Welcome back. An earthquake of magnitude 6.0 struck North India today. The epicenter of the quake was in Hindu Kush region. Tremors were felt in parts of Punjab and Jammu and Kashmir reportedly.
जब झटका जोर से आया तो हमारी दीवारें हिल गई और जमीन भी नीचे से हिल रहा था और हमें फिर लगा कि अर्थक्वेक आ रहा है, लेकिन काफी जोर से अर्थक्वेक आया, हम डर गए। उसके बाद हम नीचे जल्दी जल्दी उतरे, अपने दुकान से नीचे उतरे, हमने देखा कि अर्थक्वेक, सारे लोग भाग रहे हैं, पूरा हिल रहा है और काफी हम डर गए।
Moving on, Danish diplomats will no longer be entertained by senior government officers in India. The decision to scale down diplomatic relations with Denmark comes days after Danish authorities refused to appeal in their Supreme Court against a decision of a lower court which said Kim Davey, wanted by India for the Purulia arms drop case, would not be extradited to India. Initially, Denmark had accepted India's request for extraditing Mr. Davey, but he challenged a decision in a city court in Copenhagen, which ruled in his favor. Staying with cross-border talks, Pakistan Foreign Minister Hina Rabbani Kaur has said that Pakistan is willing to resolve all the disputes with India through dialogue. She also said that over the years, the acrimonious and aggressive relations between the two countries have declined considerably, and all issues including Jammu and Kashmir should be sorted out.
We have been able to achieve the impossible. We have been able to achieve not creating, you know, not indulging in a hostile and a negative narrative with India within the Foreign Office of Pakistan. Now that's a very, very strong message. That does not mean that we are not aware of the many challenges that we have. That does not mean that we are not aware of the fact that we have the issue of Jammu and Kashmir to be resolved. But what we are convinced is that the way to resolve the issue of Jammu and Kashmir, the way to resolve all other issues, is through the negotiating table. When we're convinced of that, then the only thing we have to invest is in building the trust and in being able to change narrative.
In another scene, a Pakistani soldier was arrested by the Indian Army in Kerni sector of Poonch district in Jammu and Kashmir. Arif Ali, who belongs to the frontier force of the Pakistani Army, was arrested at around 6 this morning. However, no weapons were found in his possession. Ali is currently being questioned by army officials. News from Pakistan. The Pakistan Supreme Court has asked Prime Minister Raja Parvez Ashraf to approach Swiss authorities to reopen graft cases against President Asif Ali Zardari. The Supreme Court has given Mr. Ashraf a deadline till the 25th of July to act on his order. Mr. Ashraf, a senior leader in the Pakistan People's Party, became the Prime Minister last month after his predecessor Yusuf Raza Gilani was disqualified by a Supreme Court bench for refusing to approach Swiss authorities to reopen the graft cases against Mr. Zardari. The he-man of the 60s wrestler-turned-actor Dara Singh, who wowed audiences with his brawn and on-screen histrionics for over 5 decades, died in Mumbai early this morning, losing his 5-day fight for life. A childhood hero to many of his wrestling prowess, 83-year-old Singh, who played Hanuman in epic teleserial Ramayanam and also dabbled in politics, passed away at 7:30 a.m. at his residence in Juhu in suburban Mumbai.
क्या लंबी जर्नी, क्या जबरदस्त जर्नी तय की है दारा सिंह साहब ने, और उनकी जितनी तारीफ की जाए कम है, बल्कि मेरा और उनके बेटे का रिश्ता और दारा जी के साथ रिश्ता बहुत जबरदस्त रहा है।
दारा सिंह जी ने कुश्ती से लेकर कला तक एक बहुत ही शानदार और बहुत ही अद्भुत सफर अपने जीवन का तय किया। निश्चित तौर से जहां वो कुश्ती के महानायक थे, वहीं फिल्मों के नायक और मानवीय जीवन के, मानवीय मूल्यों के प्रति एक समर्पित योद्धा की भूमिका में हमेशा वो रहे।
International news, over 20 people were left dead or missing with tens of thousands evacuated in western Japan after heavy rains caused massive flooding. The rains also caused landslides, crushing houses in their path. Some areas of Kumamoto Prefecture saw rains of up to 507 millimeters in less than 24 hours. Japanese Self-Defense Force has been deployed to help residents. Master Blaster Sachin Tendulkar has been named in the probables list of the Mumbai team for the Ranji season 2012-13. Apart from Sachin, Team India's pace spearhead Zahir Khan has also made it to the 35-member list. Sachin has opted out of the upcoming series against Sri Lanka to spend time with his children. Former FIFA President João Havelange and one-time Brazilian football leader Ricardo Teixeira received millions of dollars in a World Cup kickback scandal. FIFA finally published a Swiss court dossier which detailed that Teixeira received at least 12.74 million Swiss francs from 1992 to 97 in payments from marketing agency ISL, which collapsed into bankruptcy in 2011. On to the London Olympics, the military has been asked to provide up to 3,500 extra troops to guard the London Olympics amid concerns that private security firm G4S will be unable to deliver the number of staff it promised. Ministers have been forced into the last-ditch move only a fortnight before the Games because they are concerned that G4S cannot guarantee it will be able to supply the 13,700 guards it was contracted to deliver. The announcement comes 2 weeks before the start of the London Olympic Games. That's a wrap on this bulletin. I'll see you in half an hour with more updates. Stay tuned to NDTV Hindu. Coming up is news and comments.